Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going back to basic. I am going to show you how to create your first image using Stable Diffusion 1.5 right here in ComfyU. To learn how to install ComfyUI Manager and to make Comfy using model from your other web UI, please refer to the link on video description. Also, make sure you already have a checkpoint or Stable Diffusion 1.5 model saved. The default location is in models/checkpoint. All right, so open the Comfy. It should be empty. If it is not, create a new workflow. The first thing we need is to tell ComfyUI which AI model to use. Double click anywhere to get you search node window, write load checkpoint. Click load checkpoint to put the node load checkpoint into the canvas. This node allows us to select our Stable Diffusion model. Click on the drop-down menu next to CKPT name. You should see a list of models that you put on your models/checkpoint folder. Select the model that you want to use. In this case, I select Realision V60. Remember that you need to choose ST1.5 model since other Stable Diffusion model will also shown here. In this node, you will have three output, that is model, clip, and VAE. Model is going to be used by K-sampler node as a base to generate the image. Clip is going to be used to connect to the prompt, positive and negative. VAE, or variational autoencoder, is a type of neural network that plays a crucial role in encoding and decoding images between the pixel space and a lower dimensional Latin space. The VAE's encoder takes a high-resolution image and compresses it into a much smaller representation in the latent space. This latent space captures the essential features and characteristics of the image in a more efficient form. It makes Stable Diffusion model able to work with a smaller amount of information during the image generation process, which is computationally more efficient. After that, the VAE's decoder takes a point in this result latent space and reconstructs it back into a full resolution image in the pixel space. Most Stable Diffusion model already has its own VAE. But if somehow you met Stable Diffusion model with no VAE, you need to add load via a node independently. Next, we need to tell the AI what kind of image we want. Double click again and search for clip text encoder prompt, add two of these nodes. Rename one node to positive prompt and the other to negative prompt by double clicking on their titles or right click and select titles. You could also change their color. Naming and color is fully optional and for your convenience only. The program will careless about that. Code is where you put our human language to what we want on the image and what we don't want for the image. You should refer civita.com for example and guide of how to write the prompt for each model. Now, in this case, I will add this prompt in positive prompt. One girl and realistic crowd point four and pics of tree one theater perfect illumination distinct Bishojo 1-2 Unreal Engine side lighting perfect face detail face beautiful eyes, pretty face, so bright skin, 1-2, idle, soft smile, upper body, dark red hair, a simple background, S, dark backgrounds, a depth of field, and add this on negative prompt, bad picture, chill, 75, deep negative, V-Hun 2750, bad and V4 is quality 2, worst quality 2, low quality 2, a normal quality 2, Loris 2, a bad anatomy 2, a bad hands 2, a watermars, a Malia 1, 1-5 Foz, a freckles 3, 1-5. In this negative prompt, I add some embedding, but you could remove them if you want to. I will explain embedding in future video. Also, those in bracket with number next to it after the colon symbol represent their power of influence. The normal value is 1, so you don't need to write it. Larger than 1 it means it has more influence than other prompts. Less than 1, it meant that it will have less influence than other prompts. Drag the clip output from your positive prompt node to the positive input of the load checkpoint node. Do the same for the negative prompt node, connecting its clip output to the negative input of the log checkpoint node. Now we need a node to actually create the image. Double click and search for K sampler. Bah, add this node. This is the core image generation engine. Drag the model output from load checkpoint to the model input of K sampler. Drag the positive output from your positive prompt to the positive input of K sampler. Drag the negative output to the input of K sampler. Now we only need one more input for the K sampler, that is latent image. Back to our explanation about VAE to optimize computation, stable diffusion need work on latent space. So we going to create empty latent space. If you have image that you want to change, it called in painting, and please refer to link on video description about how to do in painting. For now, we're going to generate image from nothing, double click again, and this time search for empty Latin image. Add this node and change the size. Most that's to 1.5 will train using 5.5 model 12 to 768 pixels of width and height, so choose that range. You could always upscale them later. In this example, I use 512 pixel width and 768 pixel height. Connect latent from this node to latent image in key sampler. Now, let's watch K sampler. It has a few settings. Seed is like a unique key for your image, so every seed with the same prompt will generate different image. If you use the same seed with the same prompt and with the same setting, it will always return the same image. Control after generate, decide how your seed change after every generation. It could be fixed, increment, decrement, or randomize. Steps determines the number of denoising the K sampler will perform. Higher steps generally lead to more refined and detailed ailed images, but also take longer to generate. Lower steps are faster, but might result in less coherent or detailed outputs. The optimal number of steps depends on the chosen sampler and the complexity of the prompt. Or classifier free guidance scale determines how strongly the generated image will adhere to your positive prompt compared to the negative prompt or the unconditional generation. Higher CFG values tend to produce images that more closely match the prompt, but can also lead to oversaturation artifacts or a painted look. Lower values can be more creative, but might deviate more from the prompt. A value of 0 effectively disables guidance. Sampler name allows you to choose the sampling algorithm that the K sampler will use to denoise the latent image. Different samplers have different characteristics in terms of speed, detail, and the types of artifacts they might produce. Scheduler, in the broader context of diffusion models, refers to the algorithm that manages the iterative denoising process. It dictates how the noise is removed from the latent image at each of the steps. Think of the sampler name as selecting a specific recipes. The algorithm and the scheduler itself is the set of instructions within that recipe that tell the AI how much noise to remove at each step and in what way. Refer to your model page for information of recommended sampler and scheduler, or experiment yourself. Denoise is particularly relevant when you are not starting from pure noise. It means if you do in painting, which means changing an existing image, when it determines how much the input latent images denoises according to the prompt and the chosen number of steps. Higher now denoise value, closer to 1, means the K sampler will deviate more significantly from the initial latent image, adding more noise internally as if it were starting from a noisier state. This allows for more substantial changes guided by the prompt. A lower denoise value, closer to 0, means the K sampler will make smaller changes to the initial Latin image, preserving more of its original structure and content while still being influenced by the prompt. Of course, since we use empty latent image, then this means we need to give it the max denoise. Now that we've finished all the setting, we need to show the image. Since the output of K-Sampler is latent space, we need to decode it to image, so we'd need decode image node. To decode image, we need VAE. So connect VAA load checkpoint to decode image via input. Now the decode V result will be image. We can use preview image or save image. Preview image will show the image without saving it. Then save image will save the image. Of course, we can right click the image and do save as, select whatever you want. I suggest using preview image if you want to save some space. Now, since everything is connected, click run to see our result. The first time will be long since we need to load the model. After load model, the next generation will be way faster because we don't need to load the model again. Here I create a bad result, but if I refer from civitai.com, I supposed to use this setting. Negative prompt add realision negig is embedding sampling method DPM plus plus SDD with Keras I sampling steps 12 with CFQ3 and clip skip 1. Now the result is better. Now I will add random prompt in real time and we see the result together. Watch out for conflicting prompt like writing to hair color, skin, or put the same thing in positive and negative prompt. So I hope this beginner-friendly guide has helped you take your first steps into the world of AI image generation with ComfyUI and StayUI and Stable Diffusion 1.5. Don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful and subscribe for more AI art tutorials. Let me know in the comments what kind of images you create. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Please subscribe.